2,950 point blank kills. Right now, that's how many you need in order to unlock all of the gold guns in Vanguard and to get that Atomic Mastery camo. This is a lot of point blank kills, and unless you know the best methods for getting them, they can be very frustrating. I found that once I started using a couple of subtle tricks, the point blank started coming in nice and quick. These tips are so effective that I even managed to get 29 point blank kills in one game with the Kar98K sniper rifle. In this video, I'm going to be showing you the best way of getting point blanks in Vanguard, covering everything from class setups, attachments, game modes, playstyle, you name it, I cover it. Also, the advice I give will work for every single weapon, and I'll have a specific section about the sniper rifles at the end of the video, so make sure you stick around for that. If you enjoy this camo challenge guide, then please do leave a like, it helps a lot. And if you want to see more content like this in the future, hit that subscribe button and you'll know whenever I post a video. Let's start off by talking about the best class setup for getting point blanks. Alrighty, it feels good to be back in the creator class making these camo guides again. This is my first camo guide for Vanguard and I'm so hyped about it. Let's get started straight away though, there's no messing around here. So this is the overall class setup that I have been using whilst getting point blanks on basically any weapon. I would say the perks and the tactical are pretty much dead set, you cannot change them, but the lethal can be changed if you want to. So starting with the perks, we are running Dauntless, Tracker and Lightweight. These are very much focused on mobility. Dauntless means you don't get slowed by anything, so stun grenades or explosions or anything, you just don't get slowed, you are a machine that just keeps on sprinting at your enemies. Tracker makes it useful for basically tracking down enemies, knowing where they've gone and how to get behind them in an easy way. It's also great for following enemies through smokes, which is the tactical we're using, so it's a great combo. And then Lightweight just simply gives you move speed, which means it's easier to catch up to enemies, sneak up behind them, just outmaneuver them, whatever you need to do to get these point blanks. I did just mention it there, but this is very, very important. We are running a smoke grenade in the tactical, and the point of this is to basically cut off enemy lines of sight and give yourself the ability to get up close to enemies, get in their face, get behind them, whatever, get those point blanks. It's so much easier to get close up to enemies with smoke grenades because you can just cut off those long angles and then take whatever route you want down the middle of the map or whatever it is. I cannot stress this enough, the effective use of smoke grenades is crucial for getting point blank kills. As for the lethal, I've been running a Molotov or Thermite. This isn't that important, but I just use them to cover areas that I don't want enemies to go through. So for example, if I'm pushing through a door on my left, I'll chuck the Molotov somewhere else to the right to stop anyone pushing behind me and getting a free kill on me. And if you watch the gameplay closely, that will start when I've covered the attachments for guns, you'll see just how I use Molotovs to do exactly what I've just said. And it's a subtle thing, but it can help you stay alive a bit longer. And that's everything you need to know about the class setup. Let's go into the attachments. And for this example, I'm using the STG, but I'll talk you through the general principles, and it's more or less the same for every weapon in the game, except snipers, but I'll cover that later. In this game, there are so many attachments. There is no one size fits all. I cannot say like these attachments hit on your screen right now are the best for every gun because it changes. These attachments aren't necessarily available for every gun. So the general theme of what you want to achieve with your attachments in order to get more point blanks is you want to have the fastest sprinter fire time possible. You want to have nice hip fire accuracy, and you want to focus on move speed as much as you can. On some weapon classes, getting that move speed is very easy. Like some SMGs have the gung-ho proficiency, which is just insanely good for mobility, moving around, getting those point blanks and hip fire kills. But others like the assault rifles and LMGs do not have this luxury, so you've just got to find that move speed elsewhere in your build. Sprint to fire time is really important, and a good place to get this is in the stock. And this is because basically the faster you're able to shoot after sprinting, the better, because you will be running around the map like a madman most of the time. As soon as you see an enemy, you want to be able to react and shoot them straight away. So using attachments like this stock on the STG really help with that, and this also gives move speed, so it's just a great attachment for what we're trying to achieve. Another example of what we're focusing on in this build is in the underbarrel. The M3 ready grip gives us some aim down sight speed, which is nice, sprint to fire speed, and aim walking move speed. You will find some attachments don't directly contribute towards this hip fire, sprint to fire time, or movement speed goal. So for example, this magazine, it actually loses move speed, but it gives us damage, so it's kind of worth the trade-off. Also, on guns where this is available, the recoil booster is a great attachment because it gives you increased fire rate, so up close and personal, you don't really care too much about like your recoil or how inaccurate you are, because you're not gonna miss that much when you're right up in their face or just stood behind them shooting them in the back of the head. So increasing your fire rate at the cost of some accuracy is absolutely fine. I think that basically covers everything we're trying to achieve with the attachments on any weapon setup. So just to reiterate, focus on sprint to fire time, movement speed, and hip fire accuracy. Let's get some gameplay going, and I'll talk you through the game modes you should be playing for point blanks and how to adapt your playstyle in order to maximize the potential for how many point blanks you can get each game. So the game gameplay you can see right now is me working through my MP40 point blank challenges, and I was basically just putting everything into practice, and it really wasn't too bad getting these done. First of all, the game modes you want to be playing are Blitz on any game mode, whatever you want to do. Probably not Search and Destroy though, or Free for All. Maybe Free for All though, but preferably not. It's not that great. Or you want to be playing the Das House 24/7 playlist. This is a relatively new playlist where you're playing Vanguard's equivalent of like Shipment, Nuketown, whatever you want to call it. And another game mode option, which is coming out relatively soon, which is going to be great for point blanks, is Shipment. Sledgehammer have confirmed that they are putting Shipment into Vanguard, and I believe they said it was going to be on the 16th of November, so it's about a week from when this video goes live. So as soon as we have access to it, that is going to be the best place to do these point blanks. Now, as for the playstyle, in order to get loads of point blanks, hopefully the gameplay will show you this and it will be easy to understand. But the general principle of what you want to do is spawn, smoke off a long angle on the map you're playing, and then either run directly towards the smoke and use it to go down a route that gets you behind or next to enemies, or you can sit in the smoke and wait for enemies to push through it, and then it's just a free kill as people just walk right next to you and you kill them easily. Or you can even just run straight through the smoke like a madman, no one will expect it, and then you might even be just behind enemies, or you can just catch them off guard and get some nice point blank kills. Some examples of subtleties on how to improve your use of smokes is on Das House, and there's plenty of examples in the gameplay of this. Basically, depending on where the enemies are on the map, it depends on where you want to smoke. If the enemies are pretty much spawn trapped at the back of their spawn, then you want to smoke as deep as possible down the long middle corridor. This gives you the most options for then routes you can take, whether you want to go left, right, or through the middle of the map. And this works because there's a low chance that any enemies are actually in the middle of the map going to shoot you down. However, if you're the team that is spawn trapped or struggling to get past the midpoint of the map, then you want to throw your smoke much closer so that it covers the middle section of that middle corridor. This then enables you to run into your smoke, and then you can go left or right depending on what you want to do. But the aim of this is to basically give yourself easy access to the big circular room on the side of the map, or you can push across to the narrow corridors on the other side of the map. You can also run the resupply field upgrade, so that then when you spawn, you chuck it down, pick it up, then you'll have two smoke grenades for that life. This means you can pretty much cover that entire middle corridor with smoke, which gives you so much freedom of where you want to go in the map. I also found that a generally good thing to do that catches your enemies off guard and helps you get point blanks is when you are coming around a corner, slide around the corner and stay like crouched when you finish the slide. This is especially effective when you are up close, because you being crouched is a massive adjustment that your enemy has to make to their aim. So it can give you that extra split second that can make all the difference to start shooting enemies first, or to get an extra couple of steps in towards them to get within that point blank range. And that's pretty much it in terms of the play style of how to get point blanks with basically every weapon except sniper rifles. So let's move on to the sniper rifles advice. Now, I feel like people are probably going to skip ahead to this section, so I'm just going to really briefly cover the class setup again. If you want to see the class setup and everything explained properly, go back in the video and use the chapters to see where I talk about it. But basically, in the class setup, you want to be using the Dauntless, Tracker, and Lightweight perks. In your Tactical, you want to be using Smoke Grenades. And then in the Lethal, you want to be using Molotovs or Thermites. To be honest, the general playstyle for getting point blanks with snipers is more or less the same as using any other gun. However, you've just got to be a bit more careful with your shots and probably a bit smarter with your gameplay as well. You will pretty much only ever have one shot to get that point blank with a sniper rifle, and if you miss it, you will die every single time, pretty much. So you've got to make sure your movement is as good as possible, making enemies miss their shots, giving you every chance that you can to buy an extra second just to get that shot off. In terms of game modes for getting sniper point blanks, I would say right now, Das House is the only good place for doing it. I've had so much success in that map, it genuinely surprised me. I was not expecting it to be that good, but there's just so many options and so many ways you can outplay your opponents to get close and get those point blanks. Whereas on maps like Dome or just general maps, even if you're playing Blitz on them, it's so hard to actually get across the space and really consistently get close to enemies. So Das House is just perfect for it, I found. However, once again, when Shipment comes out in about a week's time, that will probably also be the best place for sniper point blanks. I still feel like Das House will still be a strong contender for point blanks, even with snipers, because I mean, it works very well for me right now. Like literally, I said at the beginning of the video, I managed to get 29 point blanks in one game using snipers on Das House. That is pretty ridiculous, and I am perfectly happy with getting that many point blanks in one game. But to be honest, I think the most important thing for getting sniper point blanks is in the attachments on your snipers. So Let's head over to the gunsmith and I'll talk you through what you should be using, because this is very important. Okay, this is the sniper attachment setup that I've been using on the Kar 98K. Again, we are focusing on sprint to fire time, hip fire accuracy, and movement speed. I'll very quickly run through each attachment. So the L-break gives us accuracy, no cons, brilliant. The barrel gives us aim down sight speed, which is nice. The optic gives us the most aim down sight speed possible and is good at close quarters because it's just an iron sight. The stock is very important. It gives us a load of move speed, aim down sight speed, sprint to fire speed, and aim walking move speed. It's just a great attachment. In the underbarrel, we're using the pistol grip, and this gives us loads of sprint to fire speed and hip fire accuracy. Fantastic. We're not using magazine. None of them are at all useful for what we want to do, and I don't think any of them are even that good for just general sniping either. The ammo type, we've got subsonic. This is just because you might as well use something here, so we'll take ourselves off the minimap with this one. Then in the rear grip, we are using the fabric grip. This gives us aim down sight speed, sprint to fire speed, and hip fire recoil recovery. A pretty nice attachment, just solid all round really. In the proficiency, we're using fleet, and this gives us that mobility, the move speed that we want. And finally, the kit on hand. This one is surprisingly important because it lets you throw those smokes and molotovs much faster, meaning you're much less likely to get caught out throwing them, and you spend less time throwing them and more time sprinting. I was genuinely dreading getting point blanks with snipers, but then once I kind of put all of this together, this whole attachment setup, it felt so good. I was so surprised with how much easier it became. I would highly recommend giving this setup a go, and you will get so many more point blanks. And I hope the advice I've given for all the other weapons is helpful as well. I'm sure I'll give you loads more point blanks and you'll be smashing through those challenges in no time whatsoever. Let me know how your camo grind is going down in the comments below. I personally think the leveling is probably one of the hardest parts of the camo grind, because it just takes forever to level weapons up. But overall, I am loving Vanguard and the camo grind seems pretty fun so far. Thanks for clicking on the video, and thank you for watching to this point. I'll see you next time.